Hello again, everyone. Khonius here. Today I'm flying from Roswell, New Mexico to Albuquerque, New Mexico. Flying a new plane today. It's the Cessna Citation CJ4 jet. It has a maximum flight speed of 451 knots, which is much faster than I'm used to flying. It's also a jet, not a propeller. The cockpit is quite different than I'm used to. It's not a Garmin cockpit, but something proprietary. And so what I haven't figured out yet is how to set, where the altitude is getting set. It's probably in one of these screens. I don't see it up here, of course. Maybe that's it right there, just like other garments. Okay. Alright, so let me go ahead and... Yep, there it goes. Oops, that's not what I want. I want this to keep going up. Alright, so we'll say, 7,500 feet flight level. We want the flight director on. We'll turn flight level control on and nav. I'm going to synchronize the heading for a default navigation path. So I think we're okay. I have to remember I have landing gear too. I don't usually have landing gear. So let's just see what happens. That warning is the parking brake, so that should go away now. All right. Let's give it a go. Sure, when I'm good to lift off yet in this plane, but it kind of feels like now would work. Let's drop the bring up the landing gear. I stay at 10% climb until 10 degrees climb until I know how the plane feels. I'll need to bring up the flaps in a moment once we get to altitude.
KH311, you are leaving my airspace. Frequency change approved.
Finding it really hard to read the instruments.
Roswell,
I have to
Tower,
zoom in a
little
bit to be able to see
change.
Them. Just a lot of anti-aliasing effects.
Albuquerque Center KH311 is type Cessna C25C 2 miles north of Roswell.
Alright, flaps up.
Request flight following.
So I need to pull back on the stick a bit.
KH311 Albuquerque Center.
Alright, so for the time being, I'm going to go outside where I can see the instruments clearly.
Squawk 0277 KH311.
We'll fly that way until I get used to the plane, and then I'll go back to flying on the inside. And what I don't want to do is keep the engines at 100%. It seems like I keep seeing that you're supposed to climb at 70%. That's probably plane specific, but I'm going to just go easy on the engines, just in case. I had set a flight level of 7,500, but I feel like we're going to go much higher than that. We don't need to stay that low anymore. Go ahead and head in the direction of Albuquerque. Alright, so this feels stable. It'll take some getting used to the cockpit. Maybe they'll upgrade that display, or maybe there's something I'm doing wrong, because it looks like we're going a little on the fast side, so I'm going to go ahead and drop thrust. We'll just kind of go ahead and level off now. I believe I can engage altitude mode and it should hold us where we're at. Let's go back outside and just see if that's true. apparently. I don't want to be climbing up there. I think I know what I did wrong. I turned on altitude mode, but I didn't actually engage the autopilot. That is the mistake I made, so let's go back inside. You can really hear the wind out there, so autopilot is right there. Alright, now I feel like it might be leveling off in altitude. You can really hear the wind. Too fast, so I need to pull up. Throttle half thrust. Alright, so it's not looking the way I'm expecting. I'm gonna drop thrust a bit and see if I can figure out what the problem is. Alright, so let's go back inside. First of all, it might help if I turn on navigation. Autopilot, I think, is still engaged. Okay, so now it's dealing with heading, but it's not dealing with pitch, so it's pitching down. So, probably autopilot disengaged right now. I'm going to go ahead and keep going a little bit too far to the west just to get us back on the correct flight path. Alright, so let's go back inside. What could be going wrong here? First of all, it would be nice to get altitude hold on synchronized to current altitude. Oh, maybe that's the problem. Oh, and then it's got to be re-engaged. So let's see if that works. Okay, this is feeling better. Looks like the autopilot's flying the plane. So that's good. It's going to get us back on the exact flight path we need. Presume. Honestly, I don't know what's going to happen, but it seems to be acting normal now, and so my problems were not properly turning everything on. That's what I was missing. So what I'd like to do is try the flight level change. And so again, it's just very hard to see these panels. They really ought to fix that. Or I need to start recording in 4K. That's probably the proper solution for that. I think that's going to apply now. Yeah, I think that's actually applying now. That's fine. I want to be at 10,000. I don't want to be at 7 something. It's just there's a auto repeat thing that happens when you click it too fast. I feel like we're probably dropping too much. Oh, and that's heading, right? Okay, I need to be doing altitude. Alright, that looks good. Okay, I think we managed to survive, but I didn't hear any alarms. Yeah, I think we're fine. Alright, so target is 10K or so. Looks like we're pretty much on the right path. Not a lot to see around here. That mountain range is interesting. I would like to take the drone over there and take a look at that. And there goes the plane. It should be stable. We can always go back to this view, check on the instruments, and then go back. Okay. So let's check out these mountains over here. It's going to be a while before we get there. A lot of wide open space here. Seems like a lot of this area could be developed and people could live here, businesses could move in. Seems like we have a lot of open space. But I guess the problem is probably water. Getting water in here. Alright, so just a sanity check. And we're fine. Soon I'll need to drop altitude again to get rid of the wind. Alright, so back over here. These aren't particularly interesting, but there's not much else to look at, really. Alright, well, I'm gonna go ahead and go back. Reset the drone. Alright, let's go back inside for a minute. Might be a good idea to look around, get used to the dashboard a little bit. Again, it's very disappointing not being able to read this. I wonder if my graphics settings... I should experiment with that. But it does make it a little hard to fly from the inside if you can't see. How close do I actually have to be able to see to read those? Probably like here, and so then... you're not really getting any visibility on the outside. So I'll need to do that, do something, or change planes. There's approach mode. I wonder if that's working with ILS or something. Okay, so dump cabin pressure, interesting. Don't know what a lot of these things are. Climate control, that makes sense. Looks like we could program the whole flight plan in via this console here, maybe. Okay, what does this thing do? Where is it zooming in? Inoperative. And that's too bad. They should really make every button work, to at least do something. Alright, I'm not going to push any of those buttons. I don't know what they're going to do. Did I ever bring up the landing gear? I think I did. Probably not a good thing to do while flying. Let's go outside and make sure though. I did kind of lose track. Okay, yeah, we're good. Yeah, I'm not sure if I like this plane or not. It's fast. It's stable, but just seems a little hard to fly with the cockpit the way it is. I wonder if a faster plane though, the flights are getting a little long. Yeah, there's not much to do at this point except just kind of look at the plane, look at the ground. No real natural features out here to speak of. Just a huge, wide open space. Much to do except play music, read a book, eat your lunch. Even with this fast plane, it seems like this is taking a really long time. I could probably be going faster though, now that I look at it. Let's try to speed things up a bit. See if I can adjust our altitude. I wonder if that's within the safety margin or at what point the engine actually starts to get damaged. It's nice to be able to set a maximum speed that a pilot wouldn't let you go over, but it's not in control of the throttle. So what I'd like to do is go to a lower altitude, but it seems like my altitude changes happen immediately. Yeah, I could feel the plane dipping. That's fine, it's just I have to be aware of that, because in other planes I have to hit flight that will change again to do something like that. Alright, so we'll start heading down to 7,000. We're probably going to overspeed again, so let's drop throttle, give it a chance to descend and pick up that speed. More little hills over here on the right, or I mean on the left. Not particularly interesting, but again, not much else to look at. Might be interesting to use the drone and see what the interior of the plane looks like. We're kind of leveling off now. So I can probably put the throttle again. Get back up to speed. I'll need to keep an eye on the speed while using the drone. Before we see it just stop climbing, so let's get the throttle to a point where it's stabilized. Okay, that seems pretty good. Push to the drone. And then I should be able to enter the plane through the back. Oh, here we go. Oh, interesting. They don't usually expect anybody to be back here, so they don't necessarily complete everything. Well, I guess that was just piercing through a wall, that's fine. There used to be these external views where you could sit out the window and look over the wing and stuff, but it seems like those went away. I don't know how to get those back. But it is nice to be able to go in here and kind of look around, see what it looks like. Don't normally see the pilot and co-pilot. Let's see, where is the sun? Let's see if I can create an interesting looking shot, maybe. Alright, well, kind of interesting, I guess. Again, just, you know, huge wide open space with no real natural features to speak of. Not sure why this area is not used more, maybe it just isn't needed. Maybe there's no way to get water and power in here. I don't see any kind of electric grid nearby. Some kind of, I guess those are windmills. Let's see, can I get back to the drone? Drone's kind of stuck. Oh yeah, I'm going to be controlling the plane. They have just run out of autopilot. Let me check on that. Oh, it's engaged. Okay. Alright, I think I need to reset the drone. I hit a button and then it got stuck at this particular view. It's a nice view, but I can't get out of it. It was on a fixed camera, I get it. Okay. Whoa, a little bit of turbulence or something. Let's go back inside and see if there's any kind of a warning on the instruments. Seems to be okay. J and M phones, nice. So now, on the drone, I need to increase the speed because it's 4%, it's just too slow. But I would like to check this out. Of course, we're moving by jet speed. Yeah, not much to see, just a little farming area, I guess. Maybe some cattle or something, judging by the color of the ground. It's kind of funny, because we can just sit on the ground and the plane will drag us along. Wherever it is. Can't see it.
132.8KH311.
I don't know if we're leading it. I think we've pushed ahead of it, but I don't really see it. No idea where it actually is.
KH311 Albuquerque Center continuous planned. Altimeter tree 0.19er.
There we go. Okay. Back outside. Saw what looked like an interesting little settlement over there with some trees and stuff. Kind of like to take a look at that with the drone. So can I make it there if I don't disconnect? No, no way. Let's 100% and disconnect.
Five hundred. Landing gear. Landing gear.
Oh,
landing
shit.
Gear.
What's happening?
Landing gear. Landing gear. Landing gear.
Alright, the plane landing is gear. Having problems, landing so we're gear. Gonna switch to...
Landing gear. Landing gear.
Co-pilot.
Landing gear. Landing gear. Landing gear.
Autopilot must have disengaged after I disconnected with the drone. That's interesting. Alright. So, that's interesting. Looks like a processing plant for something. But, okay, this is the group of trees I saw that I wanted to check out. Alright, well, not particularly interesting, but, you know, not much to look at. Let's go back to the plane. So my plan was to have the co-pilot land, since it's the very first time I'd be landing the plane, and watch what he's doing, and then kind of learn from that, rather than try to have a disastrous landing my very first time. That was a little frightening, having the plane nosedive, but it seemed to recover. That had been my sort of rehearsed plan, was if something goes wrong, just turn the co-pilot on and let him take over. That worked pretty well. So in order to observe the co-pilot landing, I do need to go outside. Let's go back out. Alright, so no flaps yet, but we're very close to the airport, so it's going to be a very short time before we're on the ground. It was scary enough hearing it say 500, but then to hear it say landing gear, that was pretty frightening. So I didn't want to have to try to go back and recover from that myself.
Albuquerque approach KH311. Request clearance to transition Charlie airspace.
KH311 Albuquerque approach. Clear through the Charlie airspace.
Alright, so I'm going to look at the landing. Maybe from the side a little bit. Love the jet exhaust effect.
Albuquerque Tower KH311 is 11 miles southeast with India to land.
I kind of do need the instruments though, I need to see how fast we're going. He hasn't slowed down yet, but he will. I wonder if there's air brakes. Something I'll need to know about also.
Landing gear. Landing gear. Landing gear. Landing gear.
I guess I have to put down a landing gear.
Landing gear. Landing gear. Landing gear.
Alright, there we go. The least I can do. And he's got the flaps down, we're dropping in speed, the engine throttle is down 20% or something, so that all seems typical. Flaps are only halfway down. So that's all that's really needed at this point. Maybe he'll drop them all the way. Again, I don't know about air braking. I want to look inside and see if I can find anything out about air brakes. Probably down here. Engine starter, trim. That's lighting. I don't know. Not sure what that is. Okay, well, maybe just wheel brakes are enough. Let's go back outside and look. Alright, so we're down to 125 or so. And co-pilot's just using his own judgment on where to go, not following the landing pattern. But that seems fine.
500.
The runway's in view, so it's just a little bit of a turn to go into it. It's interesting, the landing pattern brackets are actually at an angle. It's interesting. I guess because of turning or something.
500.
Okay, I wouldn't mind seeing exactly when we touch down. Are we actually going to land on a runway or on the dirt? Maybe there's supposed to be a runway here. Okay, well, that just seems like a weird thing for co-pilot to do.
121.9er KH311.
So there must have been changes to the airport, and we've got a combination of old and new data. I wouldn't have expected it to just land anywhere. That seems kind of crazy. Alright, let's go back inside. Hit the parking brake. Turn off the engines. Oh, maybe the parking brake was already on. Why are we moving? Oh, you know what? The co-pilot's doing something, I guess. Taxiing or something.
Albuquerque ground, KH311 taxi to parking.
I better
taxiing to general aviation parking by a taxiway cross runway 30 November Mike Papa cross runway 26 Papa KH311.
Seems like the co-pilot doesn't know what the hell he's doing. That wouldn't be the first time I've seen that kind of stuff happen before. Engines sound a little, I don't know, unhealthy. Maybe I did overstress them. They don't sound as smooth as I would expect jet engines to sound. And it's having us turn into dirt, so yeah, there's a mismatch between the airport where it thinks the airport is. Looks like it's having us go down a runway. Maybe there's a paid Albuquerque airport. I should check. I don't know if I would buy it, but I wonder. Seems like this is going to take a long time. But we're not going slow. We're probably going at the limit. Oh, I guess we're going a little slow. A little bit faster. limit is 20. There we go. Yeah, I'm not sure I like this plane. I might pick something else. Maybe go to a dual prop plane or something. And I definitely don't like the layout of this airport. Like we're driving right in the middle of our runway. It is really making us go far away. Wow. Just a long, boring ride to Parkman. Not that interesting, but I do like to have my flights be uncut, beginning to end. Expose my mistakes and everything that can go wrong. The only time I've cut something out is when the video card has locked up for 10 seconds or something. It's amazing how useful both the rudder steering and differential braking is to maneuver around on the ground. Very handy. You pivot really nicely by just hitting one of the two brakes. And so parking is just up here ahead. Yeah, I'm really not feeling this plane. I kind of wanted to like it, now I wanted to like a jet. At some point I do want to fly a jet, but I have to find one I'm going to like. This way, when the arrows are telling me to go in. That's weird. I'm just gonna run them over, I guess. I'll try to go around.
Albuquerque ground, generic
sorry,
November 775 to Lima, requesting the end of pushback.
That was weird. I was just standing in the wrong
generic
place.
Generic November 775 to Lima, request to end pushback.
Park break. Engine off. I have no idea how to turn this thing off. It's probably gonna be over here. There we go. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you in the next video.